I'm Erin Lawler Patterson, the goodness chick. I'm an international speaker, life coach, author, and proud part of the Mental Health News Radio Network. Join me on the journey of empowering you to kick butt in life, not get kicked by life, addressing mental health, relationships, self-care, and giving back. So if you've been an avid listener of the Goodness Chicks podcast, I want to say thank you. We've been rocking out for over a year and a half now. Pretty exciting. Great stuff going on. And if you're looking to be a part of being able to contribute to the mission and vision that goes on with this every single week, know you can hop on patreon.com/goodnesschick. And what it is, it's contributing, whether it's $5 a month, $10 a month, or 25 bucks a month, which could be equivalent to a pizza and a large macchiato. It helps with the expenses that are involved in launching and continuing the mission of Goodness Chicks podcast. So I'd encourage you to check that out if you have a time or if that's something you feel led doing, patreon.com/goodnesschick. So today, I want to talk a little bit about something that I think pertains to a whole lot of us when it comes to how we live our life. And I'm titling today's message that you can't pour from an empty cup, right? And that seems kind of common sense, but when it comes to our own lives, not always the case. So on Monday, I'm going to be doing a professional development at a local school up the road from here. I'm talking with teachers, educators, staff members, and the focus is going to be on positive thinking and correlating that with the realities of you can't pour from an empty cup. And here's the deal, my friends, when we're now kind of ahead of us with a whole new year ahead of us, we hear all these things about resolutions and goals, which are all great, great, great things. But too often we're tired. Too often we have this mentality that I can just kind of keep going. For those of you guys that remember the Energizer Bunny, that little bunny that has the drum set, you know, in front of him, and he's bing, bing, bouncing, bouncing, and clanging his cymbals, is like just going and going. Well, at some point, right, when we keep going and going and going, we get tired. And at some point, when we're in a state of our minds that, like, I think so many of us get into, where, Erin, I have a bazillion things to do, and I just don't have time to do them. I don't have time to breathe. And there's these moments in our lives that we can kind of feel like we're going in circles, or we're really doing something, but we're not really doing anything, and we think we're doing, but we're not doing, and nothing's really happening. It's kind of like we're going in the circle and squiggling all over the place on the same path, and we're tired. And if you kind of like stop and pause and think, what did I really accomplish? And what did I really do? But I'm so tired. And there's times that our mindset, the way we're going, is just purely running with an empty cup. And it's kind of like if you go to your local coffee shop, right, and you get asked for an empty cup, right? And they're like, okay, wait, I'll put your name on it. I'm going to put Erin on that. And Erin, your non-existent coffee's up. And you go, there's no lid on it, and you just put that cup upside down and like you're drinking. Well, people would look at you like you're crazy. There's nothing there, right? And that's the same with us. There's nothing that can come out. There's nothing that can drops, no anything that can be extracted from that cup, because it's dry, because it's empty. And too often we get in these stages of life where we're like, I am so tired. Why am I so tired? And what happens is too often there's this mindset that I have to be on 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I just have to. And I'm not really sure actually where that mentality initially came from, but I know there's so many of us out there, myself included, that it's like, I have to. Do you really have to? And so it's kind of rewiring ourselves a little bit, because this is what happens when we are in this mindset of going, 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 doing so many things, and we can't even lay in bed at night without our minds going in 1,000 directions. There's something off. There's something wrong. And here's the deal when it comes to the empty cup. When the cup is depleted, right, it affects all other aspects of our life, 100%, all other aspects of our life. And when we kind of get into this rut, I'm going to call it a rut, that it's a lifestyle where we're emptying, we're giving, we're pouring without taking the time to pause, to refill. Absolutely, it's inevitable that the cup will be empty. The cup will be empty. So where do I go from here? Aaron, I'm tired. My cup, whether that's a little porcelain cup, whether that's your, you know, you got your full Yeti mug, whatever the heck it is, you know, you got your Wawa paper sleeve cup. I'm empty. I'm tired. I have nothing left to give. Well, here's what I want to send out to you. You are worth and you need to have a filled cup, right? There's nothing wrong and everything wrong with actually having an empty cup and going on that mindset all the time. And well, I will fill up when it's convenient. Well, here's what needs to happen. This is where the rewiring comes in. It can't be an option. It has to be a part of our lifestyle that our cup continues and is maintained and is full, because when it isn't, everything goes out of sorts. And this mindset can get in that, well, not only do I not have time, but if I have a full cup, that's a reflection of me being selfish because there's all these other things I need to attend to. You know, I've got to go to this, you know, soccer practice for my kid. I've got these notes and this project that's due for work. I have to make sure that this is taken, this, it's like this fest forever, right? This. Here's the deal. When our cup is empty, this is what's affected. And I said all other aspects, all other spokes in the wheel of our life, it's true. Our relationships, we are on edge more. We are tired. You're not capable of really listening and tuning into the people that you love. You're not really at that game watching your kid fully because your mind's somewhere else. You're not really, okay, I'm going to go for a quick 3.7 minute run, and your mind isn't really being paused. You're just going. And so this is really dangerous where it's like, I cannot take time for myself because there's something wrong with me. I'm being selfish. I have all these other things I need to do. When we don't take time for ourselves, we really are conveying a message that not only do we not think we're important, but it's casting this message to the people we love that their time is more important than our time to us. And I'm going to say that where it's this thinking mentality that you're a vending machine. I can come by at any point and put A2 in and those bag of chips come down, AKA, you know, I need a ride here. I put in G4, right? And now I need this right now. I need this, my lunch right now. I need, and it's this, I need from you right now. And it's this give. And this is where boundaries have to be established, that we deserve, you need in order to function. And when we have this lifestyle that we have intact, that I'm taking time for me, I'm filling my cup, the people around us that we love are also getting this message that not only are you, you know, wow, you value yourself, but hey, how am I living my life? The example we set for our kids, our nieces, our nephews, our friends, really significant and really important. Because if we don't take the time for ourselves, right, and that cup is just empty and dry, what good is it? Can't do anything with that cup. You could throw it in a washer, boom, get it washed, right? You can just set it back in the cabinet. Has no function. And at that time, at some point, we become that we can't do anything, can't think straight. Our relationships are not what they need to be. Our body, minds, and spirits are just tired. They're tired. And I'm going to break down a few things where, you know, there's light at the end of the tunnel here where it's like, okay, I'm empty. Where do I go from here? Well, the first is it's saying learning how to love ourselves. It's learning how to love ourselves. And for a lot of people, that's a struggle. Well, I'm not worthy of that. Or I love myself, but do you love yourself? And it's kind of taking these little pieces apart. And how do I do that? For me, it's making sure I take time for myself. And that might mean, like the other day, I went to get a haircut and I enjoyed getting my haircut. I feel good about myself. It's for me. It's not for anybody else. I went for a bike ride yesterday for like 12 minutes before the sun went down. All these little things that it's beginning to value you and love you, because if we don't really love ourselves, it's really hard for someone else authentically to love us. It is. And it gets really complicated. For me, it's taking time in prayer daily. You know, God, to love myself. God created us. He made us individually. Like we are like a super snowflake. There's nobody on earth out of 7.7 billion people that's the same as us. There's nobody. And that's a beautiful thing. And reminding yourself, you're beautiful. You're awesome. My lifestyle requires taking time for me. And all these little tidbits, these little bricks play a role in building our ability to be steadfast and to love ourselves. Another one that kind of does go hand in hand with this, it's learning to be still. It's learning to be by ourselves. And for a lot of people, this is something I've had to really work on over the years and I've gotten a whole lot better on, but I honest to goodness used to be just very uncomfortable by myself. It was like, this is weird. And for different reasons, I think there were times in my life where it was like, hey, if I go out and grab a bite by myself, you know, what'll people think of me? Or it's weird because, you know, I'm not with a friend or I'm not, you know, in a relationship with anybody. And I look back at it now, it took time for me to just take a step back and say, what does it really mean to be comfortable in my own skin? Learning to be quiet, learning to be still, learning to recharge. And there's so much noise in the world today. It's so easy to latch onto the noise, to distract us, to keep us from really taking time to be still, because it's hard to be still. It's hard. It's a training of our minds and our thoughts and our emotions of being comfortable by ourselves. And I was kind of excited. My youngest daughter shared with me actually earlier, I guess yesterday, it was yesterday. We were talking on the phone. She said, you know, I'm working on, you know, when I go out to go get a cup of coffee or grab something to eat, you know, working on just being okay and cool with sitting down by myself. And I was really proud of her for that, because it's really, really easy to feel, I'm going to say insecure or it's weird, but I think as we become more comfortable in our own skin and we begin to grow, realizing I look at alone time as a gift. And I mean it like this, where it's actually using it productively, like going for me to go sit on the beach for 10 minutes and just be quiet and watch the sun coming down and breathing, inhaling and being like, you know, thank you, God, that I'm alive, right? Even when things are crazy train in life, I'm here, I'm in the moment. And what do I, you know, ways do I want to grow? And there's no other me on the planet but me, to just being comfortable, not being distracted when I'm by myself. And that's huge. But this is all a process. The cup filling requires us learning and knowing and being willing to work on loving ourselves, begin to start the process of being comfortable in our own skin, you know, the aspect of silence and solitude. And I'm not saying you have to go away for, you know, a weekend and be by yourself and super silence. Like I, that would actually be very, very challenging for me, right? I'd be like, 48 hours, you know, give me a surfboard and whatever else. But you got to do what you're comfortable with and start with where you're at. So that might mean 5 minutes a day, right? Taking time to just be still. No radio, no texting, no side distraction, no convos with other people. You're just, it could be in your car. It could be on the back porch. It could be in your bedroom, whatever, fill in the blank, taking time for you, beginning to be comfortable with that pause. We really struggle with that sometimes. I know it's something I really have wrestled with over the years. And it's learning how and getting comfortable with simply being alone, you know, so that silence, prayer, reflection, what you're good with in meeting at that point and being able to try to discipline ourselves, and it is a discipline to not allow the things that we're inundated with noise-wise, you know, to distract us from becoming more comfortable with who we are, right? And this is the last one I want to focus on, where it's feeling like, because I'm going to say we don't love ourselves the way that we need to, looking at our problems, looking at our challenges, looking at our burdens as an obligation to other people instead of reaching out, extending our hearts, extending our voices, our words to say, you know, I could really, I'm going through a rough patch right now. Use some encouragement. You know, would you mind, you know, just go and grab a cup of coffee, or just, you know, I need to get some stuff off my chest and I'm going to text this to you, or a phone call. You know, can you be praying for me? We're not meant to go at things solamente. Going by ourselves by ourselves is just unhealthy. And it could be a combination of pride or worrying about what other people might think, or I don't want to be an obligation. I don't want to be a burden. And here's the deal. You are awesome, right? Whether I know you personally right now or you're listening and we've never met, you're awesome. There's nobody on earth but you. But what happens when we try to go at things by ourselves is that we're walking around with this just like invisible load of bricks on our shoulders. And we get tired. You walk three blocks, you know, with a dozen bricks on your shoulders, you're tired. You feel weighed down. And instead of saying, you know what, I need to find ways and come up with ways to unload these bricks, right? Which can be through, hey, you know, having a wingman and reaching out to somebody, or it's getting counseling. There's ways. For me, it's prayer and God give me direction and wisdom. And yo, I'm trying to walk around with these bricks. It doesn't make any sense. Help me. Direction, guidance. Trying to schlep around those bricks by ourselves is just really pointless, because we have stuff in life. We have stuff. We have hurt. We have blah. You know, October 1st, my grandma passed away, right? She was 99 years old. I know I've shared this with you guys. I still really struggle with her not being here. And the many, many other people in my life, there's times I really kind of have funky periods and different things I struggle with. And I know for myself, like there's certain people in my life I have to reach out to. And it's not a counseling session per se. It's just, hey, having a tough week, or, you know, I wanted to share a story about my grandma with you, or whatever it is, right? It's finding ways to recharge and to fill our cup, because if you go on empty and you try to pour from an empty cup, nothing comes out, nothing productive, nothing of substance, and you just end up with something that's bone dry. And you, my friend, are worth fighting for. You having a lifestyle where it is intentional and keeping a filled cup will rock your world and change your world. It'll make you better in the workplace, whether you're a, you know, teacher, butcher, baker, candlestick maker, whatever the heck you are. You know, you're a parent, a spouse, a partner, you know, whatever, best friend, sibling. It will make you better. It will make you your ability to think clearer and more lucid and be more effective in all aspects of your life. It'll rock your world. You deserve to have a full cup. And it's not about being selfish, where it's like every day I'm going to do these 27 things for myself and I'm blocking everybody out. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is filling that cup in a way that we are full as human beings. We're taking care of ourselves, that we can be more effective at loving ourselves, and then that cup kind of pouring over to other people, right? Pouring over. Think about that. Whoosh, whoosh. That's pretty awesome. You are worth having a full cup. And I want to hear from you. Shout out some times in your life where you have like, you know what, my cup was really dry, and then this is the direction I took. Or these are ways that I keep my cup filled. I want to hear from you. Bring it on. I want to hear from you. And it gets me excited to get feedback from you guys, whether it's by email, DM, PM, whatever, AM, boom, all these acronym things. You know, throw them my way. And again, for those of you that, you know, you've enjoyed listening, just kind of closing out, you know, if you're feeling led, feel free to hop on patreon.com/goodnesschick. It keeps the message going loud and clear, and I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. And I'm wishing you a truly epic week where it's focusing on filling that cup, baby. Fill me up, buttercup. Boom. I'd start singing, but then you'd run away very quickly. I'm not going to do that to you. Have a wonderful week, my friends. Peace, love, and goodness.
If you enjoyed today's episode, there's a lot more encouragement and life-kicking strategies on goodnesschick.com. Have a great day, my friends.